Everyone, it's Molly. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for being here. I am doing part two of the black based canvas with the colors of fire, with the orange and the red. And this time I'm doing the puddle in the center and blowing it out. If I remember at the end, I will try to show you both pieces of the set dried. But for now, let's get started on the blowout. Let's paint. All right, hello everyone. You will have to excuse my mess. I am painting number two, and I just left the plastic because I didn't want to waste it and I could just paint over it, over all my drips that I have from the first painting. And I will try to show you the two of them side by side when they are dry at the end of the video if you want to stick around. But if you missed the other video, it was similar to my painting Inferno, where I had two sides of color and I blew them into the center. This time for the second one, she wanted the color in the center and then blown. And I'm going to try to do it a little bit. You know, sometimes I end up blowing like a Dutch pour and I just end up with like a flower. I'm going to really try to blow in a different direction. I don't know, because the other one looks kind of like a flat. I don't know. I'll figure it out. I don't even know why I talk about this beforehand. It comes out like something else. But I am using Amsterdam Oxide Black. I'm using Pyrrole Red with a little bit of Creative Inspirations Permanent Red. Azo Yellow Deep with a little bit of gold from Creative Inspirations. Cadmium Orange from Creative Inspirations and Azo Orange. So I mixed all my colors, and that is to really get, and I've left them a little bit thicker this time, and that's really to get a good, pretty cellular reaction. So I'm gonna get my black down and go ahead and, this one is the one I'm nervous about. The other one I knew works really well. I've done it before, but these colors in basically a Dutch pour I've never done, I don't think. So we'll see how that goes. Watch my air bubbles. Let's blow this out. Okay, I don't know why I'm so nervous with this one. I don't know, but I'm gonna start with my red in the center. I did one that I called Snowflake a while ago, and that's kind of what I'm thinking, is a lot of paint in the middle and then just kind of blowing it all over the place, but I don't know. Maybe I should have done more red. I don't know. Maybe I could right here, but I don't want the red to get next to the white. This is always the dilemma that I have. I feel like I'm gonna regret that white. I don't know. I mean that red. So I'm gonna try to put the white. Okay. That's enough paint. Normally when I'm, you know, when it starts to grow and I've got about equal amount on each side, I think I'm gonna just blow this out and not blow the black over. I don't wanna like muddy it. My torch. I days, I've been doing this for years now, and some days I still feel like I've never done this before. Like, this is my first time. I don't know. Okay, I'm procrastinating. Let me go. Really like it. It's a lot of white in the center. I don't know if I want to do anything about that though. I may just send her a picture and see if she wants me to make her another one with less white, or if this is it. I think it kind of gives a focal point to burst outward. I'm gonna blow this one area. I'm very proud of myself for not just blowing this way and this way and this way. I think it's really cool. This is a lot of paint right here though. Okay, I think that fixed that little area. Having my paints just ever so slightly thicker really gives a completely different feel. It's amazing, actually. Okay, now somebody needs to tell me to stop. Nope, I'm gonna stop. I'm stopping. I mean, I'm stopping. Okay. Yes. Okay, I couldn't help myself. I touched the center, and then I ended up with this huge blob. And then I had to, I just started fiddling. So that's what I ended up with for the center, which I think it goes pretty well with the rest of this now. But I touched my finger. I was like, oh no, all the black that was on the base started coming up. But I really actually like it now. Way better than just kind of a blob of white in the middle, right? Really, really gorgeous. Such pretty. That looks like a monarch butterfly. Stunning. I love it. Oh, I hope they do too. All right, I'll show you both of these dry.
I love it.
I love it. Look at the center. Oh, that's where I just torched and blew on that a little bit to spread those cells open. And I think it really gave the center a little bit more interest than just being like plain white. Look at that. Wow. And I'm glad I kind of blew it out. I get super excited when it's in my head and I do what I set out to do. I don't know. I still get excited over art. All right. Well, let me show you. Give me a second and I'm going to put the two of these side by side so that you can see the set. I'll be right back. Okay, now I had to stand back. How pretty are the two of those together? Complement each other so well. I'm so happy with this one. All right, thank you guys for watching. Happy painting. Bye.